Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Legends of Amberland. As usual, we're just jumping on in here, and today we are heading to the east to see what's what, and probably kill some stuff, because that's kind of what we do. There's also this, which we'll poke at in a little bit. Actually, I want to check. Man, still, no fire resistance on anyone in the party. That freaking floating eyeball beholder thing is still in my mind and how it wasted all of us, but it dealt fire damage, if I recall correctly, and with no resistances, mild sadness. The Frost Labyrinth welcomes you, brave adventurers. Uncover my secret or die trying. Well, okay, we're not gonna do that yet. I wanna finish mapping overland areas. And then we'll probably spend a little while in the labyrinth. This is probably gonna be a shorter episode. I'm kind of limited in the amount of time that I have to record. We're doing work in the basement, and alas and forsooth, I'm squeaking in a recording between bouts of us doing shit. Passage Guardian, the Queen has instructed me to only let pass those who are worthy. You need to pass the test. I'll do the test of might. We have passed! The way is open! Alright, apparently we're just that good. Princess Ophelia, what you see is the palace of a wicked ice queen who managed to enchant my fiancé, Prince Rupert. He does not even recognize me. The ice queen let me stay here, probably to torment me and laugh at my misery. She has no heart, literally. I was listening and I have heard rumors that she's locked her own heart in a chest deep below the palace. I've also noticed that her dragon, which she keeps behind the green portal, has a tiny key tied to its neck. She's very angry when anyone tries to approach the dragon. That must be the key to the place where she keeps her heart. Please, defeat her and give me back my beloved fiancé. Oh. More dragon slaying behind portals. Alright. That's a thing. But, yeah. So, how you guys doing? I'm doing good. Getting ready for a weekend. Gonna be taking it easy. You know, not really video games, but, you know. Doing stuff around the house, having a good time. We are, as I said, I don't want to say we're remodeling our basement, because we're not really remodeling it, but we are giving it like a really good cleaning, which it has not had since I moved out here. So, a lot of crap to go through. I'm sure this place is just swarming with bullshit. Maybe not. Wait, seriously? Like, healing fountains? Alright, what's this? Ice Queen's Chamberlain. I humbly welcome you in the name of the Ice Queen. You're free to stay here for as long as you want. If you need anything, come to me and I will arrange it to happen. You get an impression he wanted to say something more, but was not allowed to. Oh, so are they being held here against their will? And her basement is probably where she keeps her heart or whatever. A lot of healing fountains. But I'm sure this... A chilly cell with no one inside. A dragon breeder. I'm the dragon breeder for the Ice Queen. I was stupid enough to get into this mess. I've raised and trained her dragon. She was paying so well. But now I'm trapped here. I refuse to join her. She refused to let me go. I wish I listened to my mother. She was always repeating that my greed will be my end one day, and she was right. She was so right. But still, the Ice Queen was paying so well. How could I have refused? Tell me how! Anyway, I wanted to tell you a secret. It might be useful, so listen carefully. All dragons have a weak point. Let me show you how to find it. Oh, learned the secret weak spot of dragons. Really? I wonder what that's gonna do. Maybe like all of our attacks auto-crit or something. This is just gonna be a big windy thing, isn't it? The Ice Queen is the most awesome in the whole Amberland. Anyone who does not agree will be iced. And we have, yeah, that's her heart there. But I'm, of course, going to loot this. Gauntlets of War. No loot in this empty chest. Already ransacked. I never noticed that they gave you, like, no pennies left in this chest. Someone already took everything. Alright, well, that was, I guess, a bunch of loot. I don't know if it's anything worth anything. Gauntlets of War. Plus 10% damage. So the question then becomes, is 10% damage worth more than 5 strength? I don't know. Let's see, 323 on the high end. Oh, she can't wear, oh, she's got Gauntlets of Accuracy on. Ooh. I mean, we have the gloves of strength, which are plus 12. I mean, those are going to chunk. Where did... There's her girdle. Oh, maybe they're not going to chunk. Crap. I mean, I could give them to Devon. Actually, we could give them to Brynhilda. Let's see, 34 versus 52. That's a bit of damage. Versus 156. Wait, what? This accuracy? Oh, is it because... No. Do a couple points of strength really make that much difference? Yes, they do. Holy shit. Oh, no, it's because she was encumbered. Okay. All right. Well, in that case... 52... 64. That's probably the most damage she's going to be able to do, but I think I value her having accuracy more, honestly. I'm tempted to get rid of the amethyst necklace on Swell and maybe give him the boots of dexterity. Honestly. But I think I'll hold off on that for now. Like, that's the thing, is like everybody's got fairly good gear. So yeah, I think that's... I mean, those gloves of strength are great. Plus 12 strength, don't get me wrong, that's wonderful. But of all that stuff, I think that's the only one that is actually, like, upgrade-worthy. Alright, so let's get the fuck out of here. And go see about maybe killing a dragon. I wanna check. Let's see, where do we have, like... We have titles. Here we go. Huge damage bonus versus dragons. Oh, really? I'm curious to see how huge this bonus really is. Let's see what else we got here. A luxury room. A chamber filled with lavish furniture. Perfectly clean and ready for guests. Enchanted prince. The lavish room is occupied by a prince. He hasn't even noticed you. His eyes look strange and he's totally immersed with his own thoughts. Also, he has purple sideburns. I can respect that dedication to the color purple. It is, after all, the best color. And anyone that disagrees is demonstrably wrong and also probably a heretic. Just kind of map everything here, and we have some crystals here, which, sure, why not? Three, oh, these are five. I just noticed now that, like, they're bigger. Alright, that's quaint. So now we're back up to 30 crystals that I'm probably never going to spend on anything. Because I think we've... Well, no, actually, I take that back. I should go back and look, because I think we've got an extra craftsman, haven't we? So there might be new magic crystal things that are actually worth buying again. It's going to be hard to top those cloaks of displacement. Welcome, welcome. You're so cute. Why don't you stay in my palace for, like, let's say forever? Why don't you drink with me? Nah. That's no problem. You can come back anytime. And then we can drink. Alright. I'm surprised she didn't try to, like, murder us or something. I mean, we're gonna save and do it, of course. Because I gotta know. You drink the crystal goblet and it tastes fantastic. Your senses sharpen and you notice how beautiful and awesome the Ice Queen is. It would be a crime to defy any wish of such a magnificent being. Ha! And that's a game over. You were foolish enough to drink from the crystal goblet. You were enchanted and we became slaves of the Ice Queen. Stupid enough to fall for the Ice Queen's trick. There's no limit for some hero's incompetence. Hey, they fixed the adventure lasted bug. No longer is it years, now it's just days. Holy crap, we've killed 1,300 monsters. That's a lot of corpses. Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. Go kill some dragons. So, naturally, the first one I'm going to go for is not hers. It's going to be the black dragon that's way back here because his cave has some really good shit in it. So let's see just how substantial this damage bonus really is. I'm gonna give us every buff we've got. And here we go. God, that thing has a lot of health. 500 damage, 800. All right, so we're hitting really damn hard. I don't know. I assume it will not affect our casters. But still, what is this thing resistant to? It is only lightly resistant to fire. Alright. 300 damage, not bad. Wow. Almost 1,000 point damage crit there. Oh, come on. Yes! Fucking Brunhilde coming in with the clutch. Entire party down. Brunhilde leaps wildly upon the black dragon and, like, claws its eyes out with her bare hands. Nice. Black plate armor, crystal shields, all kinds of good stuff here. We'll get the fuck out of Dodge. We're getting the fuck out of here. I gotta heal. Go gain a level or something. I don't even know. Holy crap. It's a thing. Yeah, right here. Go fucking. I don't think resting. Yeah, I was gonna say, I don't think resting will bring them back either. We gotta pay money out to ye olde temple. Oh, there's a heal all button. How convenient. Oh man, that was a clutch crit that ended that thing right there. I don't even know how much she hit for. I thought it had like 1,700 hit points left, and she just one shot it. So I don't know. Wow. Okay. So shield upgrade for Swell. A shield of thunder. I could give that to Devon actually. Maybe. Yeah. Featherlight helmet. Weighs 1, armor 6. Yeah. If I can squeak that in on somebody. She's good for... Alright, here, we'll give it to Brunhilde. So now she's got 3 pounds. I can probably actually give her... a shield. It'll have to be one of those small shields like she used to carry before I gave her, like, the Blade of Heroes and stuff. Alright, so Onyx Plate. I don't think that's... I mean, it's not bad, but again, he's got that fucking plate mail protection. You have the Black Plate. Fucking full resistance complement, almost. That's really good. See, I'd be tempted to give it to Chunk and Brunhilde, and those two, like, everybody's getting protection from their armor. And Devon in just no way can carry that much, sadly. Fear and petrification resistance on the helmets, though, is pretty nice. Brunhilde could actually... She'd be doubling up on the petrification. Fear's not that bad. I'm gonna give one to Devon. And if I had to guess, that's probably gonna be it. You have a crystal helm. Which. I could actually give it to Brunhilde, but then again, she's losing a shield. So she'll have better armor with a shield. And this, actually, the crystal helm doesn't do anything for her because she has lightning resistance and petrification resistance already. Chunk, you're also fine. Alright, so yeah, I guess that's about it. We could get this Onyx Necklace. Confusion, fear, and mesmerize resistance. But like, it's good, but I don't know that it's like that good necessarily. I don't know if it's good enough. I'm gonna actually give Devon, god, he's got fucking lightning resist from 3 places. Ew. I'm gonna give him the sapphire necklace just to give him the cold resistance. But that looks like about it. Alright. Let's see about levels, maybe? No? No? No. Holy shit. Alright. Apparently levels are for the weak. Well, let's go kill this lady's dragon. And, get on with it here. Alright, we're gonna save. Because I'm a coward. How hard can it be? Oh, yeah, this... We're not even gonna buff. Fucking 1200 damage from the casters. So in that case, I assume that the dragon hunting bonus that we got, it applies to their spells, because like that was a lot of damage they shouldn't have been doing. 9600 experience points, I'll take. Like, that's worthwhile, and we got the key. Let's go ahead and we're gonna rest. I didn't bother restocking our food because I'm a dumbass, but you know, hey. All right, there's that. There's her heart. So I figure I'm supposed to take this back to the princess then? Do these things say anything different? No. Those are the same loot messages, even though it's a bigger chest. Should be something like, your party is so disappointed that Rove kills himself in the background. I'd think it's funny. Rove, probably less so. All right, so is it just you? You must go through the green portal, defeat the dragon, use the key. Once you have the heart, you should be able to... Oh, okay, so we actually might have to fight her. Probably not. It's probably going to be like a cutscene, but... Air quotes, cutscene. I'm going to save regardless. My heart! How did you... Take it away! Take it away from me! Yeah, we're going to approach her with it. No! She collapses, sobbing in front of her throne. All power has left her, and she drops a scepter. 10,000 XP. So did we actually get the scepter? Yes. Icy scepter can be used to undo the damage inflicted by the Ice Queen. So does that mean now I can come down and pester this jackass? You touched the prince with the Ice Queen's scepter. The enchantment was lifted. Oh, what's going on? Oh, the queen, what have I done? Really? Oh, that's... Oh, thank you. If it was not for you, I would be trapped here for the rest of my life. I cannot express my gratitude. But I will give you 2,000 experience points. Okay, now let's talk to her. We have left for the Iron Keep and we're going to get married there. I'm so happy. Thank you. Thank you so much. Regards, Princess Ophelia. The Iron Keep, huh? I don't even know where the Iron Keep is. We may have encountered it at some point. We've probably encountered it at some point. Let's see, is it this one? No, that's Sand Castle. I love it. Iron Keep. We may have been quested by this guy to get her, I can't remember. Yeah, my nephew has returned, all thanks to you, as I've heard. And he brought with him a cute princess. Not bad at all, I'm so relieved. I thought he would never see him again. Take this gold, you deserve it. Another 12,000 gold pieces. Jesus Christ, I have so much money. Like, if this game had one failing in my eyes, it is the economy. It is not good. So let me check. I mean, I guess I can sell a bunch of stuff here. I'm actually, I think I'm gonna just... probably sell most of this. I'm gonna hold on to that Ring of Grand Wizards. I'm gonna hold on to this Onyx Necklace. That seems like something that could tentatively be useful. But that's about it, I think. Alright. Wrong place. Oh, we got levels. I assume just like the front row has levels. Yeah. These guys are getting close though. That counts for something. Replenish food. I want to deposit these. And I think that's everything. And say, hey, there's the princess. We got married and now we're living in this castle. I'm so happy. It's all thanks to you. You've not visited Benedict Delgard, who's my uncle of my beloved Prince Rupert yet. Please do so. He said he wanted to reward you. Yes, well, we've already done that. So, what I want to do is port us back up here, because otherwise I'm going to forget about this, And next time here, we'll just park our asses in here so I know what we're doing next episode. But for the time being, I'm going to go ahead and call it. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. Hope you all had a good time. I do apologize for a slightly shorter episode today, but I will catch you all next time. Until then.